All right, guys, we're checking out a tour of the Airborne Museum in Fayetteville.
Look at those parachuters.
Wow. Hey, it still says greetings from Fort Bragg, North Carolina, right there. They're going to change that, I guess, now because of all the liberals. Anyway, it's very nice in here. We got to always remember to honor our veterans because all gave some and some gave all right for the freedoms that we now have. It's very cool here. German MP40 submachine gun. Gravity knife. Those are gravity knives are illegal to carry in North Carolina, probably everywhere. He's all decked out. I don't know, but I'm assuming one of them's a regular parachute and maybe the other one is a backup, but I'm not sure. There you go, give them both barrels. That's what I'm talking about. These are really cool posters. Check out the old Jeep here. And Italian Aeromoto Vulgrafo Parascooter. Interesting. It's really cool. Some really cool. I like the old posters. Sales pitch there. Become a paratrooper. Jump into the fight. Strong in the strength of the Lord, we who fight in the people's cause will never stop until that cause is won. Right on. So this is, well, that's a picture of what I'm in right now, but this is a picture of how it actually was. All of them sat down ready to jump out. From Salerno to Anzio. A French World War II helmet. Fusil MAS-36. M1 Grand, of course, semi-automatic rifle. It says Africa Corps uniform. Heck yeah, that's what I'm talking about.
That's real, right? Or is that a rubber?
Yeah. I'm assuming they're real.
I am too.
We got the rocket launcher. The U.S. Army 2.36-inch rocket launcher. And the MG-34 machine gun. US M1A1 carbine semi-automatic. Johnson M 1941 light machine gun. The Italian Beretta M1934 pistol. And US code M1911A1 pistol. Really cool, really cool. Men of the 504th Parachute Regiment worshiped in an Italian church in the Panaro sector on 12 December 1943. They were invited by the civilian population. Services were held by Captain Keel, chaplain of the 504th Paratroop Battalion. Cool. I don't know if this will pick up on the camera or not, but these things are like holograms. When you get closer, it looks like they're actually paratrooping down. It's probably really hard to tell on here, but it's pretty neat. All right, guys, this is not a Call of Duty game. This is here in the museum. Looks like Call of Duty, huh? And get the knuckles. Okay, this 32 caliber Colt pocket pistol. Uh-oh, there's another one for her.
Put that barrel on that thing. There's something else.
It's a Sten gun. Huh. The suitcase radio is really cool, huh? I can't breathe it. There we go. This is a decoding silk. That's crazy, I tell you. Wow. Thank you. the Hitler tyranny was doomed here, then we might pause in thankfulness and take hope, not only for victory on all fronts, but also for a safe and happy future for tormented mankind. Prime Minister Winston Churchill, Reflections on D-Day from his history of the Second World War. Almighty God, our sons, pride of our nation, this day has set upon a mighty endeavor. These men are lately drawn from the ways of peace. They yearn but for the end of battle, for their return to heaven or of home. Haven of home, I'm sorry. Lots of history. Is interesting about the stripes that they had to put on the planes to alternate in three white and two black, so they would know distinctively that, you know, they were, which aircrafts were foe or enemy. I mean, friend or foe, rather. French phrase books, German phrase books, Mosin Nagant rifle, and the Browning automatic rifle. Mechanical cricket. It says 101st Airborne Division paratrooper used mechanical crickets. All right, y'all. I'm thinking I might need to get me a haircut like this fella here. I'm not too keen on, you know, the war paint, but that hairdo, I can get down with that. I don't know how to speak French. Croix de Guerre.
lagoon. I don't know.
There's a field telephone.
Exhibits are alarmed and under continuous video surveillance. Tampering with alarms, exhibit cases, or reaching, climbing over rails is a federal offense. Violators will be prosecuted.
I'm not going to show you everything, guys. You'll have to come to Fayetteville and check this stuff out, because there's a lot to see in here. A lot of rich history about the World Wars. All right, guys, I'm going to kind of speed through some of this a little bit. I'll give you a good glimpse anyway, right? There's some mortar rounds. Light mortar. Liberator pistol. Thousands of Liberator handguns were dropped to the anti-Japanese patriots in the Far East and China. The weapon was called the Woolworth gun because it was extremely cheap to make, costing approximately $2.40 to make.
Day of infamy.
Smoke jumpers protected. Come on. How cool is that? British folding bicycle. There's a flare gun, flare pistol. All right, got the Thompson M1. It's a beacon, really cool. Antennas. Also an antenna. If y'all want to assemble one of these gliders, here's how you do it, all right? You got to check it out. I ran out of my last 5 years, but back in 82nd, to start
Hill 420, here I come.
Corporal Rudy Hernandez was part of the company assigned to defend the hill outside the small Korean town.
No flash photography. M1 Grand again, a PPS 43, an M1911 45 cal right there. Yeah, about. We got a bus to JFK. Right. The Swedish Carl Gustaf. Really cool, really cool.
And for part of the Special Forces Operation Detachment, or A Detachment. It was the basic Special Forces unit and was designed to conduct guerrilla operations.
Y'all can see there's just a lot to look at and read and learn. Some history that you probably don't know all of, right? I know I don't know near enough, so it's a really cool experience. That's a grenade launcher. M60. No. I'm just checking this Special Forces A Detachment out.
The Soviets undoubtedly knew that they were there, but the fact that their targets would have been the dissidents or the elements that they were going to try to recruit undoubtedly gave the Soviets a...
Tricks of the trade. Boots with soles that left barefoot tracks were used by Special Forces long-range reconnaissance units to fool enemy trackers. That's pretty freaking awesome, right? Night Strikers to the rescue. I ain't gonna be able to read down. This decanter was captured by General Manuel Noriega's limousine by Sergeant First Class Ron Johnson during the U.S. invasion of Panama.
Cool.
Got the Twin Towers over there, I see. Yeah, Desert Storm, can't forget that, of course. World Trade Center. Flight 93. All right, guys, we coming to the end of this tour here. History does not entrust the care of freedom to the weak or timid. President Dwight David Eisenhower. We sleep safe in our beds because rough men stand ready in the night to visit violence on those who would do us harm. George Orwell. Anyways, guys, Airborne and Special Operations Museum here in Fayetteville, North Carolina. Y'all got to come check it out. Peace. Y'all be good at it. Don't forget, nothing tastes better than a hillbilly pig roast.